This is the smart modular watering system, designed to water your plants automatically at the right moment. It will also let you monitor some useful data, like the level of the water reservoir, the UV index, temperature, and humidity. I will quickly show you how to implement a project like this. First, you will need to solder some parts, a UV sensor breakout and an IT tiny microcontroller that will send the water level data via I2C. Start by securing in place the SparkFun Blynk board and the relay module into the 3D printed housing. Connect the relay module to the Blynk board. Waterproof with some epoxy the circuits that will be exposed to the elements. Connect the soil moisture sensor to the Blynk board analog input pin. Drill some mount holes and then secure the 3D printed housing in place. I secure with hot glue some screwless terminal blocks for the 5 volts and 12 volt rails. Secure the voltage regulator in place with hot glue. Install your power source and all the wires in place. Before connecting any of the wires, I recommend to thin them first. Connect all the grounds together to the common terminal of the relay. Then connect the water pump ground terminal to the normally open pin of the relay. Connect the voltage regulator output, the Blynk board voltage input, and the ultrasonic distance sensor to the 5 volts rail. Connect the sensor's ground, clock, and data signals to the Blynk board I2C port. Connect the voltage regulator input and the water pump to the 12 volts rail. Using a step drill bit, drill the water overflow holes and the distance sensor holes to the water reservoir. Then cut a hole big enough to fit in the water pump. Assemble the irrigation system using some clear tubing, end caps, and parts compatible with your water pump. I suggest using a filter for your water pump and your water reservoir. This will prevent clogs in the irrigation system. I made mine with a coffee filter and a 3D printed cage cube. Install the water pump and then fill up the water reservoir. Insert the moisture sensor into the soil and then connect power to the system and it should start working normally. Once you make sure your system works, you can add a cover, a roof, and you're set. You can find more details about this project in the video description below.